Hi everyone, I just wanted to go over again how to get all the drips off of the bottom. This is off of serving tray, many drips, and also coasters, big drips on the bottom. So we're going to remove them. And this is a nice tool to use, just a putty knife. This is a flexible one. It's a little bit flexible. So anyway, heat gun. Throwing high. Oh. Gotta keep it off of the material I have here, because it'll burn it. My heat gun get up to temperature now. Alright. So let's see. Once you heat it up, it comes off fairly easy, as you can see. But I don't get off with the heat gun, I just use some sandpaper. It's coming off rather good. And I'll take my sander. This has like a 320 grit on it. 240 grit. That's about all it takes. Now it's ready to paint the back side. So we finished. Beautiful. Now I'm gonna do the coasters. You can just sand these off, but I think it's better to do it this way. Now these stands I have, maybe I'll do a video on those, show you what I did. I saw someone, it was someone else's idea. So I tried it, and I'll tell you about that in another video. Sure makes quick work of it. This system works very well for me. I'll let you know, I just poured these yesterday, so I'm imagining it would be a lot harder if I waited longer and longer. I wait. Anyway, the top looks good. The bottom's nice and smooth. And what I'll do is I'll paint the bottoms of these, and then I'll do some Suede Tex flocking, which puts like a felt or suede on the bottom of these coasters. And on the back of this, I'll paint this. And then I'll put these felt pads on the bottom. I'll put 2, 2, 1, 1. So I'll have 6 total on the bottom of this. And that way it won't still a little bit soft since I just poured it last night. You can see stuff sticks to it. It's soft, but it'll be just fine. It will just be fine. They turned out pretty nice. I think the person who's going to receive these will be very happy. Paint the bottom of them with the same paint that I started on the top, which is just a latex paint and primer in one. Okay, so I went ahead and I painted the bottoms of all these, and then I sanded them down with some 220 sandpaper, and now I'm ready to put the finish coat on. And here's what I do. I have this paint from a long time ago, Suede Tex undercoat adhesive. It's like a paint and a glue in one, colored adhesive, I should say. And then it has also this suede flocking material, which is a powder, and I'll put some in here. So I'm ready to go. So I stir this up. I just use this little brush, cheap acid brush you can get Harbor Freight. Really cheap. So I take this paint and apply it liberally. And as soon as I have the paint applied, I flock it. Just shake this. And I make sure I put a lot on. And that's it. And I do the next one. I don't worry too much about getting it on the sides because it'll come off. It's a little rubbing after it's dry since it's the epoxy. And I very simple. Very simple. Nothing too hard about this, except it makes a little bit of a mess. And you need to wait about at least 10 hours for this to dry. I usually wait longer. And then I just have to wait. I like to wait overnight. It's somewhere around 7 o'clock, 7:30 at night now. So tomorrow afternoon would be good, you know. That'll be like 14 hours, something like that. It says to wait 10, but I find I need to wait a little bit longer. Takes a little bit longer to dry, maybe because it's old. Hello everyone, we're back. I let these dry And now I'm going to show you how I finish up my whole project here for the serving tray and coaster sets. So, you see, I'll just take this, dump off the excess, and then give it a little rub. Gets it all off. Makes for a very nice finish there. And on the edges, I just go around with my nail. And you can see it, just a little bit that went over the edge. It comes off. You just clean up the edges. I'll do it with a towel. Rub, and that's done. Top's nice, the bottom's nice, and that's how I finish it. Actually works better with the paper towel than it did with my nail. I love the finish it gives them. It's wonderful. You can feel the slight resistance of the adhesive, but it comes right off the epoxy. And it's been about 18 hours since I did these. Since I did these with the suede text. I think it's a beautiful finish for the backs. It won't mar your furniture now. I think they just turn out just great this way. Now I take this. And put it back in the bag. Because it's not cheap, but it goes a long way. goes quite a long way. You do waste a little bit. So anyway, that's that part. So they're done. So then now I have this, the serving tray. All I did was paint two coats of paint and primer in one, in the same color I used as my base when I did the top. Okay, so then I have these handles I just bought at Home Depot for $2 a piece. Take the screw, since this is only 1/4 inch MDF, I had to cut the screws. To cut the screws, I just use one of these electrician's tools, and the screw screws right in the 8/32nd part. Get it in as far as you want, and then you cut it off. But be very careful, because this is very sharp in here. You don't want to get your fingers in there. Actually, what I did is I used a clamp. I put the screw in. I used this clamp and just put it like this and tightened it up as it closed, and it cut it, so I didn't have to worry about my fingers getting in here. Because one time I got my thumb in there and it cut the bejesus out of it. So be careful. So I cut the 4 screws. I have a 5/32nd drill bit. And I have one of these nice Craig cabinet hardware tools, jigs. I'll put it on there. Just start one of the holes. I do it in reverse. I'll put it in reverse to start, just to get started. Then I'll put it on forward. I put it on reverse just so I don't chew up the top. On through. Once I'm through, I widen it a little bit by moving it around like this. I'll get a longer screw and put it in there. And now that goes right on through. So then put in reverse. Just to start it. And then forward. And a little around. Now you can take that out. Put my screws in. One. And on the back side. Just barely screwed in till it's tight. And there you have the one handle. Now do the other handle. Doesn't have to be exact. Put it in reverse. Let's get it started. Then forward. We go around. Do the other one. Oh my. Hold that thing on there. Alright. Now the other one. Just enough to tighten it. Okay. So now you see I have the handles on. And you have a beautiful, beautiful serving tray. But on the back, now that I put these handles on, these screws are protruding and will scratch up whatever you put it on. So what I do, just like I put a very nice soft back on this so it doesn't mar tables and very nice and attractive. On these, I use these heavy duty felt pads. And I just get them at Home Depot. I think this whole pack was like $10 for 96 of them. So I put 6 of them on here First, I just need to cut them. Then you just peel the backing off. And I put it about a tiny bit away from that screw. And just press it on. Put these on for stability. So there you have it. Okay. Now let me show you. Out of the way there. Now it's nice and stable. Nice and stable. And I have a beautiful set of coasters that match the serving tray. And the backs have the velvet, or the suede, I should say. The suede backing. And there you have it. That's the finished set. I hope you enjoy this, and I hope you like my piece. I think it's pretty nice. And you have a nice day.